Yon!
Yon,
Episode! Yes! Parang iPhone 10! Yes! Oh my goodness. Thank God. Thank you, man. Hindi madali gumawa ng podcast. Thank you so much, Merk, also helping with logistics and all. I mean, alam mo, kita niyo naman sa mga mata namin. Paras kaming ano eh.
I mean, kami, oh.
Grabe. I mean, minsan to aim na kami. Parang, uy, tulog ka na. Tama na yan. Mga ganun. Diba? Like, we're forcing each other to take care of ourselves. You know, some of us had their second dose. So, you know, we have to take care of ourselves. So, Hopefully, no? Hopefully, ngayon na nag-episode. Yeah! Episode.
Ten.
Yeah! Tayo.
Double I know. Nila, hopefully,
medyo tayo mag-next level sa mga next episode. Hopefully, we can bring in more guests and everything like that. And yes, we're just few days away from the official, no? Beginning of the day for the registration of candidacy for 2022 elections, right?
Wow.
And as of this recording, parang isa lang yung super sure na top candidate, si Isko, no? Hindi pa rin namin alam so far, okay? So as of this recording, so it's possible by the time na lumabas ito, kasi kailangan namin edit and everything, no? May day job din kami. Dalawa pa yung mga day jobs namin. Kung mga third job na namin to. Baka may mga developments na. No? Hindi naman kami Madam Auring, but we have a sense that, I have a sense, Marcus will run for the presidency. Like, if he doesn't run, I'll be really, really shocked. Like, so I think the Marcus have played it smooth. But we're not just gonna talk about Marcus. I think Marcus should be a big issue here because I think Mark agrees that Marcus could be the guy to beat talaga. I mean, he might be really the most dominant contender in these elections. I know na quote ako ng mga pro Marcos people, but to be clear, this is not an endorsement of him. It's just reality. It's just the facts on the ground.
Paglabas ng mga bagong batch ng surveys, BBM might be number one. And
yeah, or more or less statistically tight sila ni Isko and Sarah or something like that. I mean, within the range.
With Sarah backing out.
Especially if Sarah backs up. But my sense is, even if Sarah stays, I think Marcos could still do pretty well, no?
Yeah.
I think that trend lines are in his favor. So we don't know if Sarah's gonna run. Marcos said kind of like, he thinks talaga baka she'll not run or parang he hopes that she'll not run. Na. Mm-hmm. So even the Marcoses are sending feelers that they're counting on Sarah not running, no? Manny Pacquiao, Senator Pacquiao, has kind of made it clear that he's not kind of sure what he's gonna do. So, back na naman tayo sa negotiations for a united opposition, which brings us to the woman of the hour, right? So, for the next hour, yan ang pag-usapan natin. Vice President, duly elected Vice President Lenny Robredo. Yan ang pag-usapan natin today. Okay, Marks, anong gusto mong pag-usapan natin? Last episode, medyo ano ka eh? Hot seat ka eh?
Yeah, medyo harsh kasi ako minsan kay VP Lenny and the opposition. So this episode,
totoo yan.
Siguro
alam mo magpakabait ka na, daming galit. Sabi, bakit yung kasama mo, 'di ba, Isko yan? Bakit galit na galit yan kay Lenny? Sabi ko, hindi, he's just trying to play the devil's advocate. The same way hindi ako anti-Isko when I raise certain questions, right? I think people pretty much know what's my stance on Isko, right? Bala kayo sa buhay.
Joke lang.
Ano?
Galit talaga ako. Joke lang.
You know, once upon a time, lahat secret dilawan. Let's just put it that way, siguro. I mean, once upon a time, we took it for granted. Yung ano narrative ng ETSA, di ba? I mean, let's just be honest.
I don't hate them as a person. Yung kanilang strategy lang, I don't like. Siguro, this episode, yun ang gusto kong malaman.
Yes, pag-usapan natin yan.
Pag-usapan natin. Ano ba ang...
Go.
Strategy ni Lenny. Di ba, lumalabas na Lenny and all that. Since, of course, alam naman natin, marami
path, tayo. My path ba? My path to victory ba at all?
Yun ang gusto kong malaman from you, to say. Richard.
Right.
Kasi from our side, from our vista, I will be honest,
yes.
Parang wala. So, so this episode, I will be quiet. I will be more of a listener. I will try to learn. So, pag-usapan natin. What can Lenny do? Lenny wants to lead, pero how will she win if she decides to run and she listens to her supporters na tumakbo? Kasi no question naman, yung base ni Lenny is very ano din, talagang solid din with her and passionate about her. No question about that. And of course, marami dyan mga well-educated, mga matatalino, mga professionals. So,
right.
How do you translate yung passion na yan for Lenny and to make a campaign that can win all the way to Malacanang? And right. Especially now na Bongbong Marcos might just be the main opponent or the main candidate to beat dito sa halala natin. So right. Let's start. Where does Lenny stand right now sa pagkakaalam mo?
Right. So let me start with some premise, no. So my premise here is that Bongbong Marcos is the guy to beat in this election. Okay. I'll just start with that premise, as simple as that. And that is a very important thing, right? So if you look at it, all elements are coming together, no. Medyo magulo yung kampo ng mga Duterte. So hindi lang yung United Opposition ay disunited, medyo magulo din yung Duterte kapto. So there's the Bongo element, there's the Sara and the Father element. 2015, siguro nag-work yung mga antics na I run, I do not run. Pero this is 2022. I'm sorry. You cannot pull off the same game. And if it's not scripted, then that it's even worse, right? So if talaga may mga frictions, so clearly, the Marcoses were playing it quiet for quite months. Hindi nga natin alam anong nangyari kay BBM, right? Biglang, since early September, wow, may interview with the Anvil Club, mga Filipino-Chinese community. Very clear si Bongbong na the VP numbers don't make sense for me. And I think there's a clamor, you know what I mean? There's a public clamor that we run for the highest office. That was early September. I think things keep on improving for him since then. He already has an endorsement from the party that his father founded, KBL. So he didn't say no to the endorsement. So it's just a matter of like intermission number pa, di ba? So building momentum at saka yung message discipline, napaka-discipline yung Marcos. You could see these guys are experts. I mean, they have really planned this for a very long time. But, and I think they're really sensing it. This is the moment. This is the moment that the full Marcos restoration could happen, that Imelda Marcos could go to the staircase and say, we are back. Yan! Eto na! So I think you can see in there, you can see my shoe senses, my thousands. You know, she's my jewelry. So, of course, those are all gifts to her. We know, right? Wala naman talagang, walang kinuha sa kaban na ba. These are all kindness of the world to her. But, Yamashita. May voltes, So, I think the Marcos is right. They have the grassroots. The authoritarian nostalgia is coming back. They have the machinery. They have the message discipline. I think meron sila mga level, mga Cambridge Analytica level of advisors. I'm not saying Cambridge Analytica, but yung mga level of advisors, I'm feeling global level, no? Baka mga British, whatever. Everything is there, no? If you look at Bongbong, he plays very simple. Hindi siya bastos. Hindi siya kumakagat sa mga attack sa kanila, no? I'm sure they're emotional. They get angry. Anyone would get angry, especially when inattack yung, you know, the late father among other two. But in fairness, no? You could see na, eto na, this is a ready army, no? Like, oh my God, if they're gonna come, they got it out. So, that brings me to Lenny. Because if you watch Lenny nung 2016 elections, if you watch documentary na Kingsmaker, you watch everything about it, parang all the time sila ni Lenny, she's here to make sure Marcos doesn't return to Malacanang, right? Now, if that was the argument for vice presidency, that's even a bigger argument for the presidency itself. So it just doesn't logically make sense to me to say, well, I mean, I did my job, you know, I'm vice president. Yeah. But, you know, now there's a real deal. It's actually the presidency, right? So great, you survive all the court cases and all. And then the other thing, bakit ka tatakbo ng vice president kung hindi ka tatakbo ng president? I mean, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, it just doesn't make sense, right? I mean, obviously, you're there to go all the way, right? So, yan ang sense ko, no? I think the last one who didn't go, was it Noli De Castro, right? I think, okay, medyo hindi nangyari kay Noli De Castro, but with Binay, he tried to be president. With ERAP, he successfully was able to do it. With Gloria, a little bit too successful. I think she didn't want to become the president right away. So, you know, I can give an on and on and on, right? So we have a lot of precedents where the vice president runs for the president, and in many cases, actually, they succeed, no? So let's keep that in mind. So for me, on that level pa lang, there's no point for Lenny not to run. But the next question is, does it make sense for her to run at all, right? So of course, the myth of the Lenny, solid Lenny people, oh my God. For lack of term, let's just put solid before everyone. The solid Lenny people's argument is that, well, she went from 1% to vice president, right? And she beat the Marcoses, what, 3 times in the Supreme Court. So that's the line of the Lenny team. And just to be clear, I have not even had proper interview with Lenny. So my level of interaction with her is very limited. Probably had more time with President Duterte or definitely Isko and even with Marcos. Si Bongbong, kasama pa kami, co-speaker pa kami dati sa CU. So just to be clear, ha, this is not like tinawahan ko si Madam kanina at ito, magpo-podcast kami ng mga gagong to mga kami. Walang ganun, no? I know she follows me on Twitter. So I know that. And I know, and so I'm aware of those things. But just to be clear, wala akong illusion na, I mean, like I'm an insider or anything like that. I'm just a journalist and an academic. But of course, people know my convictions. I believe in liberal politics. I'm not pro-liberal party. Those things are very different. No? Liberalism is actually against oligarchy and all. But anyways, moving back. So that's the myth, right? And myths are not 100% wrong. Sometimes myths can turn out pretty right, right? And okay, my argument is this. Okay. So the 1% to the vice president makes sense to a certain degree. But of course, the problem is, back then, there was the machinery of Liberal Party, right? Tom Aquino and all of that. There was Mar. You have none of that. And from what I hear, Mar people may be actually betting on someone else. So that explains. Maybe Mark can tell me more about that. So that's a big issue. The machinery is lacking. At the same time, of course, the counter argument to that is that in 2016, mabango magabango si Duterte, right? And the Marcoses look like inevitable victors. Well, both of those are under question right now. The Marcoses were not able to show their dominance, right? They were like, you know, para silang kawawa, korte na korte, na walang napupuntahan. As for Duterte, he's still popular, sure, but I think the bloom is off the rose, right? Wala yung freshness, yung excitement. Wala, in fact, there's a new survey that came out that 60% believe unconstitutional for the president to run for the vice presidency. So, you know, I'm just saying that, like, take the popularity numbers in context, because I think a lot of Filipinos say, okay, tama na, let's move on na. So the counter argument would be, the advantage of Leni Robredo this time is that, first of all, she's just not some nobody, right? Because no one knew
quantity. Oh.
She's a quite known quantity. Her approvals, by the way, are still majority. By the way, she's not, her approval ratings are 50, 55, 60%. So, like, it's not good. Like she's like 10%, right? Let's be very, very clear about that. The other thing is that she was also able to prove, well, hindi siya kurakot. I mean, that's very clear. Inang beses siya ng top ng COA. She did pretty okay. And just to tell you, Mark, I've also seen random people. By the way, I'm in mask. They're in mask. So no one knows no one. They said they want to vote Lenny, right? Of course, I'm sure many also like Isko. But there are many people also like Lenny. They're just not as vocal online. Or maybe not vocal when survey comes to them. Baka maman, baka pag sinabi ko gusto ko si Ma'am Lenny, baka mamaya mawalan ako ng ayuda. You know what I'm saying? Like, you can never discount that possibility in a climate of fear. Let's just be very brutally honest. So wag tayo masyadong titignan yung mga nangyari sa online, because a lot of that is artificial. A lot of people are scared to say anything positive on Lenny kasi attacking ka na lugaw, dilawan, bayaran, whatever. So, and of course, Lenny, for me, has proven also her mettle, because she was able to withstand assault on both sides. You know what I'm saying? Like, in strategy, you never want a two-front war. No one won it. Napoleon never won it. Hitler never won it. Like, no one can win two-front war. It's very hard to pull that off. Well, guess what? Lenny at least survived a two-front war, which is both President Duterte and the Marcoses. In fairness to the woman, I'm just telling you, like, whatever you want to say, good luck. Put yourself in the shoes being squeezed between Marcos and Duterte. Yeah. Good luck with that. Like, ako, may patikim lang ako nakita bilang, you know, when the trolls are attacking me. But I think that's nothing compared to what the Vice President Leni Robredo has been going through. So some people are saying that, you know, she despite all the attack and propaganda against her, she's a much more proven quantity. She's much more a sharpened knife, right? And the conviction and the confidence level with national politics there. And by the way, over the past 4 or 5 years, hindi naman siya nakatulala lang dyan. She has been going around the country, going around the world. So there's some exposure and respect. And by the way, let me tell you, Mark, abroad, they like her a lot. She's very respected abroad. It's quite the opposite. They don't like to tell her that much. I'll just be brutally honest. Yeah. Not the OFW, so. Of course, the OFW is love present to tell. I'm talking about the international community, investors, media, whatever. Like, Lenny, ang bango na pangalan. I'm just telling you, go to DC, Paris, even Hong Kong, I don't know, maybe not Beijing, but Japan, Australia, like Leni Robredo, they love her. She's invited to give talks in universities, etc. So let me just be very clear about that. European Union, they all love her. So let's get that clear. The other argument I'll make is this. The unity team negotiations have not been going well because it's just, I think masyadong foggy yung situation, right? First of all, we don't even know who's gonna run and not run. I mean, like Sarah not running will be a big factor. I won't say the biggest factor.
I'll ask you about something, ha? Kasi ito yung
yeah, go.
About the United opposition. Kasi ang criticism, yung moves for a United opposition is parang a ploy lang for others to back out and Lenny to be the only candidate left. Na yung United opposition na wala namang they're not open to other candidates na hindi si Lenny. So what can you say about dun sa mga allegations?
So parang, I see. No, I mean, but didn't Juan Sambayan, I'm not saying Juan Sambayan is the kind of convener, but didn't they endorse Isko? I mean, I don't know. I mean, they endorse Isko in graceful.
Isko is a possible options, di ba? Parang right. Mumukha lang na maraming possible options.
Ah, so parang sinasabi mo, ano lang to? Parang lutong makaw to, parang ano lang to?
It was always going to be about Lenny. Na kung hindi din si Lenny, this United opposition will not work. So
let me say this again. I haven't heard anything directly from either Yorme or Pacman or Lenny herself. No, but from what I know, there were genuine negotiations for the past few weeks. In fact, over the last weekend, my negotiation this time Pacquiao again discussing. So I've heard the Pacquiao Tulfo thing. We can discuss that. But it seems Pacquiao is also realizing. Who knows? Baka binabasa niya ako or yung podcast natin or whatever. That a presidential run will be really, I don't know, I'm not saying burning money, but it's really, it's hard to justify it. You know what I'm saying? Because Pacquiao doesn't have a passionate base. I mean, even if you say Pacquiao has almost similar number to Lenny, yung passionate base ay kulang.
Malayo.
Yung Lenny base is so passionate and marami sa akin na they're middle class, upper middle class, you know what I'm saying? Yes, Pacquiao has money, sure, and everything. I'm just saying and the thing is like Pacquiao, many are saying he's a good guy, but maybe he has to be vice president first, which is, let's be brutally honest, both of you and I are arguing that. And who knows, maybe we'll vote for him if he runs. Maybe
put him in a position na hindi nakasalalay sa kanya muna yung buhay natin.
Medyo OJT muna.
Hindi niya responsibilidad yung our lives.
Kasi mukhang bata-bata pa yung next president natin, whoever, no? Medyo the lineup.
Kasi syempre yung pandemic, it's a matter of life and death. So,
right.
Hindi biro.
No, I mean, I'll just put it this way. The guy has been so busy boxing. I'm not sure we have seen the statesman in him yet.
Yeah.
So I'm not saying he's not for it. I think he can be a great statesman. We already discussed he could be, I think, the best vice president ever. I got a lot of bashing for that. But I genuinely believe that. I am, thanks to you and our discussion, actually, he could pull off a lot as a vice president.
So yun ang tanong, so I think, is it possible? Ano, are you hearing something na possible yung Lenny-Pacquiao tandem?
I think it's possible. I mean, I could be proven wrong any moment. But it looks like increasing possibility. In fact, I'm hearing a lot of LGBT Lenniers or Lenny people or liberals are saying, well, I mean, we didn't like what he said, right? But it's not like demonyo si Kuya, or it's not like he's the worst, hindi siya mamamatay tao, right? Hindi siya pro-dictatorship. Hindi naman siya magnanakaw, right? I mean, you could see naman he has genuine love, right?
And so, could just vote for him.
Yeah, or yeah, exactly. Lenny. So they might not punish Lenny or like get super mad at Lenny if ever that happens. So Pacquiao suddenly doesn't look as and I'll tell you another thing, no. In fact, the story that is coming out, you're free to disagree with, is that the Pacquiao is more the crusade opposition guy than Isko, and that's why the Isko Pacquiao thing didn't work, because the argument was that Pacquiao wants hard investigation on the Farmali, Duque, potential, who knows, even EJK issues and all of that. Well, of course, we discussed that in previous episode. Nuance yung position ni, or at least so far in the election period, si Isko. So I think, at least tactically, there was not an agreement. So if you are a liberal opposition, you will be more okay with Pacquiao. Yeah. Because if Pacquiao is in a crusade mode, and he will be an attack dog guy, and Duterte runs for vice president, that would be very, very interesting. That's like Pacquiao going after Duterte during the vice presidential debates. I mean, I popcorn's ready, man. I'm here to tweet on that.
And I think it makes sense strategically kasi kahit mababa yung numbers nila pareho, if they join together na
right.
And hopefully baka magsama yung ano nila, then medyo mas
And by the way, Poe most likely will not run even for vice president, right? A lot of Poe numbers could go also to Lenny. I'm telling you, right? So I mean, Lenny could go to 15-20%. I mean, it's not impossible. I mean, maybe 30 will be hard, but 15-20 doesn't look impossible.
And that's,
I mean,
may laban ka na nun.
May laban ka na. I think at 20%, you're competitive. You're not leader, but you're competitive. So what I'm saying is that we are underestimating the potential for a four-way fight. Yes, some will be more like, it could be really a kind of a Isco versus Marcos maybe at some point. But if Sara runs, yeah, if Sara runs and Danny runs, it could be a four-way fight. So it could be kind of like this version, right? Yeah, it's kind of squarish. Medyo higher lang konti nung dalawang lalaki na ganun. So that's a very, that's, then anything can happen, right? Again, I could be wrong, but I'm just saying, if Grace Poe steps down and Grace Poe is already at 10-15%, right? You can say 5-7-8% of that could go to Lenny. And so if Lenny has 5-7%, that's already 15%. And if Pacquiao backs out, maybe 5% goes. So I'm saying Lenny could actually go around the number of 15-20, which is not the worst way for her to start compared to 1% in last election. I'm just giving you the math here.
Ito, since I was very tough on Lenny for the last 9 episodes natin, medyo mabait ako ngayon.
You were just playing devil's advocate. Just to be clear to folks, hindi po siya anti whatever. Let's just be very clear. Otherwise, ayoko ko siyang kausapin. I'm kidding. Go.
pero teaming up with Pacquiao might just give her enough reason to run. Kasi di ba yun ang pinag-uusapan niya ngayon?
And for Bongbong to join. That's my point, bro. If Bongbong runs, and then Pacquiao backs out and Lenny backs out. Grace Poe backs out. Makes sense. I'm sorry. Just mathematically makes sense. And then, yes, the donors now may be more on Isco side or already the other side.
Yeah.
But donors are donors. They can, you know, Duterte, how much yung backing niya nung September 2015? Later on na lang, lumaki yung spending ni Duterte, at least based on official numbers. So I'm telling you, like, Lenny might not start in an ideal situation, but she can start in a pretty competitive situation. Let's see what happens with the Poe and Pacquiao vote, the double P, if ever they don't go now for the presidency. I think there's still room. I think there's still room for that. And I think Lenny's counting on the anti-Marcos passions to mobilize her base, right? And then, going back to Isco, some of the things that Isco said is being twisted or interpreted as enabler. So that could also help maybe Lenny's case. I don't know. I'm just telling you. So why I'm saying Lenny's case is not a hopeless case. It's not a hopeless case. It's not a hopeless case. I'm just saying that. Let me just openly say Lenny's case is not a hopeless case. If she doesn't run, I understand. But it's not a hopeless case. Especially if Poe and Pacquiao don't run. And if Sara doesn't run, then who knows? It could be even a three-way fight. Isco, again, no offense to other candidates. I'm just being brutally honest because my passionate base is Lenny, my passionate base is Marcos, my passionate base is Isco, right? My momentum is Isco. I cannot say that about the other candidates. I'm just sorry to say that it's just not there. I mean, you can say
that. Genuine, whatever. Opposition versus administration versus third.
versus center.
Yeah.
Exactly. Which will be interesting. That would be fun. That would be really, really fun. I mean, that would be a nice triangle, right? That would be very interesting.
It would change the dynamics. Maski dun sa plano, dun sa kampo namin.
Absolutely.
Kasi we have been preparing only for a big fight with the administration.
The other side. Exactly. So which brings me to the next level of discussion. Thanks. I really like this discussion. Kasi, again, I have no insider whatever, but I hope they're going to listen to what we're saying here. I'm going to tweet on this soon. Because I like this discussion. I think it makes sense. I mean, hindi ko pinipilit to. I mean, I have no stake in this. I mean, I have preferences, but I have no direct stake because hindi naman ako pinaramis ng specific camp or anything, right? So, which brings us to the second level. Nonetheless, at some point, there has to be a decision where will the opposition ultimately rally behind. So, if Isco loses steam, which is not impossible, but unlikely at this point, then at some point there should be a rallying behind Lenny and Isco could become the next Grace Poe. I'll just be brutally honest about it like that. So that's one scenario, not very likely for a lot of reasons we have this, but that's one possible scenario. And I think Lenny people are hoping that now Isco will kind of deflate. He's just a man of the hour or the month. Pagdating ng February, wala na. He'll be like another Grace Poe Escudero, right? I think that's the hope, right? Now you kasi Mar still not number 2 si Mar, di ba? But the problem is it was not enough in the case of Mar. So Mar gained over Poe, but not enough. So still Duterte won. So you might have a bad scenario whereby Isco loses steam, but Lenny doesn't gain enough. to beat the other side. That's a bad scenario. You don't want that. You don't want that. Because I'm not sure the ISCO people are willing to rally behind Lenny. But the other scenario is that Lenny stays in. She keeps it at around 10-15%. I think this is a very probable scenario. Again, I could be absolutely wrong, but she keeps at 10-15%. Then ISCO goes between 20-35%. You know, he goes there. And then Marcos is somewhere between 20-25%. Then at some point, some Lenny people could say, okay, we want to throw off some of our 5-10% to ISCO to just make sure ISCO gets the 40-45%. Right. So maybe Lenny doesn't have to even back out like officially, but they can send feelers on, hey folks, this is not about how, I mean, I know you love me, but you know, this is about yung pakanan ng bansa. So there could be some rallying behind in that moment. Of course, that also raises the question for the other side. What will the Dutertes do if they don't have their candidates there? Will they try to make a deal with ISCO, rally behind ISCO, rally behind Marcos? So that will be interesting because I don't think ISCO people will rally behind. I don't think ISCO people are composed mostly of never Dilawan. I don't think so. So that's going to raise... So you can see them...
That's where we disagree.
What is this disagreement? I don't see that ISCO people has never Dilawan a lot. Are they?
I see marami sa amin. Yeah.
Then maybe I'm wrong. Again, of course, by the way, we don't have any focus group discussion. So this is... These are smart guesses at best, right? But sige. So, of course, the scenario you don't want to have for the opposition is for Lenny to start pretty okay, decent, 10-15%, and then get stuck there, and then stick it there, and then ISCO loses too. That's a bad scenario. That will be essentially 2016.
Yeah.
So I think that's the ghost of 2016 is there. Their preferred scenario is ISCO starts strong, 20%, Lenny 10-15%. Maybe Sara doesn't run, or both Sara and both BBM run. They kind of split 40-45%. Then ISCO loses steam. Then there's a rallying behind Lenny. Lenny goes to 30%, 25-30%. But this goes down to the wire. This goes down to the wire. Wow. Then that mahirap yan, bro. So my question to the Dilawan people will be, can you produce the warm bodies? Because this is the argument I can make for the ISCO people. If ISCO people lose under very suspicious circumstances by a very small margin, ISCO people can produce the warm people. Like, ton of people will be out, right? So the question for the Dilawan people is that in your best scenario, where ISCO loses steam and Lenny gains ground, becomes kind of like how Mar gained over Poe, right? And even better than Mar and goes to 30%, right? ISCO goes down to 10%. But Bongbong is also at 30-35%, right? Or Bongbong and Sara at 25%, 30%. And it goes down to the wire, just like last year. What are you going to do? What are you going to do if she loses suddenly? And while you feel that she should have won. So that is where there's some serious issues because let's just be honest, brutally honest about it. So if you see, my argument is that I think Lenny should run. My second argument is that she could actually be very competitive. But my third level of argument is that she could, but even in the best scenario where she's very competitive, which will unfortunately mean something bad for ISCO potentially, it's still down to the wire. And still there's gonna be the second level of challenge, which is not the election per se, but how the election outcome will be. Will be tabulated everything like that.
Yeah.
So, oh man, that's gonna be hard. So, that's where it's hard to bet talaga on whether Lenny will be the next president. Really hard. So, it's gonna be really, may paka mini people power and dapat mangyari dyan. I'm not endorsing. Let me be clear. I'm not endorsing. Let me be very clear. Baka ma-retag tayo. Just go die. Just, I'm just saying, hindi naman yung revolt, but I'm saying like they have to produce warm bodies just in case, right? You know, people on when I say warm bodies, not how I gonna like you know, you have to show strength on the ground. Kasi statistics sa survey, pwede mo i-question yan. Yung online, pwede mo i-question. Pero once you have 100,000, 1 million people on the streets, medyo mahirap i-question yan, no? Force yun eh. So that's my challenge. Yan ang hamon ko sa mga Leniers, solid Leniers. If in your best scenario, you might go to 30-25%, which is not the most likely scenario, let's just be honest. It's still gonna go down to the wire, right? So how is it? So my my argument would be a more realistic hope for them is Lenny stays there, stays at around 5, 10, 15%. But Isco keeps doing well, 30, 35%. And then at some point, the Lenny people should send the feelers and say, maybe we have to go behind Isco. That looks like a more realistic, not necessarily preferable, but more realistic scenario you can look at. But at least, let me make it very clear. If Lenny is there, at least that segment of the voters have a say, have a voice, have a seat at the table. Because if they're going to leave it to Isco, quote-unquote healing president Isco, I'm not sure that their version of Philippine politics will be as much reflected. I don't know. I just don't know if Isco will go against the Marcoses on issues like martial law, issues like human rights, like corruption, the way that Lenny would have gone. So I believe let Lenny really do that herself. And then if later on Isco is really the more credible one, the more competitive one, then so be it. They have to really make some hard choices. But at the same time, in their best scenario, if she surges to 30%, which will panic the other side, this could go down to the war. What are you going to do? So you have to think about that too, because that will not likely happen with Isco. I think this is where Isco has a strong case to make. If I win, there will not be a kind of chaos and all, right? Yeah, please go ahead. Yeah.
Sige, sorry to cut you off. Ito naman ang next na tanong ko. How about for Lenny's ground game? Kasi ngayon nakikita ko yung ground game sa partner Isco. Of course, yung kala Sara, that's automatic kasi ano sila, administration sila. So marami sa incumbent side sa kanila. Are you seeing yung sa ground game ni Lenny na gumagalaw na ba?
Yeah. I mean, Lenny is doing decent in NCR, and I don't think she'll have much problem going around NCR. But it's important she gets Pacquiao, because she has to have some sort
of... No. I mean, ground games, LGUs, and...
Wala, mahina talaga, bro. Mahina talaga. Magiging malaking
issue. Can you win without that? Yun ang aking ano.
Yeah, you cannot win without that. I mean, I'll be honest. Both Isco and Lenny will have that problem. Mm. Isco may have a better position. I think Isco is hoping my defections more.
That's what's happening camps. Now, unti-unti.
Yes.
Hopefully, dumami.
And I think Vico Soto being in Ascenso also helps. Yeah, I think, you know, like Lenny could obviously strong in Bicol to a certain degree and NCR. Yeah. No chance in Solid North. No chance in those areas.
Kung si Pacquiao siguro yung vice
but if he gets niya. Pacquiao, he might have a little bit chance. By the way, Lenny did very well in Mindanao in the last elections. She did way better than Marcos from what I know. And if you want to make claims, well, Supreme Court already decided, and this is under Duterte's time. So let's be very clear about these things. So, you know, as I said, the 10 to 15% looks realistic to me. Surge to 30%, some extraordinary stuff should happen. I don't know. But a problema kasi, many LGUs may be scared even to host Eleni team because nga baka madrug list silang bigla, diba? I mean, let's just be brutally honest, that was the case in 2019 elections in many ways, na parang there was this whiplash threat, no? So it's gonna be really hard, it's gonna be really really hard, but her hope will be to balance Luzon, Bicol, so 2B, and then parts of Mindanao if Pacquiao is with her.
Visayas then.
And parts of Visayas, she did pretty decent, I think, was it in Western Visayas, I think the last election, so it doesn't look like impossible. But for her to surge to 30%, it would really take some very interesting convergence of factors. But, you know, this is politics. This is politics. Much will also depend on how hard the 30 people want to play this. Because they played it very hard in 2019. Kaya talaga box out yung opposition. Eh. Kaya na 8-0, di ba? Can they do that the same? Maybe they can. Maybe they can. Maybe they cannot. I don't know. But you're right. The ground game generally is still favoring the incumbent. Let's just be brutally honest. Whether Sara or BBM, both of them will have the upper hand. But you know, Mar also had the upper hand and Binay in the ground game. But you know, that
didn't make them win. Marami late.
Because I'm not gonna name names, but there's certain governor who's now congressman who a lot of us know. He endorsed 3 candidates in the 2006 election. So I think you may know who this person is, right? So marami mga ganyan, mga bamboo effect. So like, I mean, again, let's say under some scenario, Isco loses steam, like how Post lost steam in February, March, right? Of last elections, then you know you can expect them to rally behind someone else, right? Let's see. So. But you're right. I mean, we're really looking even at the best case scenarios. They have to be really prepared to pull it off, to, you know, all in na daw sila. No?
All in talaga. And, ito, I have another question. I have another question.
Okay, go.
Ganda pala yung ganitong format eh. Pero,
this is nice.
Yeah, ano ang feeling ng Lenny crowd na with all the defections moving to Isko? The liberals, eh, mga liberal stalwarts.
Yeah,
mga,
of course, of course.
Na, di ba, like, Samira and Erice and all the other, ano, yeah. Kanina yung si Grex Lagman, anak ni Edsel. So ano ang feeling?
Must be hard. Must be very hard. Yeah, must be very hard. I think there are many ways they can look at that. By the way, Samira, I love Samira. I mean, like, again, I'm not endorsing her as a politician. I'm just saying she's a great person. God bless her. You know, whatever she does, I support her because I think she's just a good person. Yeah, as simple as that. Well, their attack would be, I think, like this, based on the comments I'm saying. Because whenever I comment on Isko now, basta hindi ko i-criticize Isko, ako yung binabash. So I'll just be brutalized. So you can say it in my page and all or Twitter. Tingnan nyo, binabash ako. I just put, lagay ko lang, Isko, may bash na. I-S-K-O, may bash na. You know what I'm saying? This was not the case. This was not the case 2 weeks ago. Yung makikita rin na may .is. Ayan, bash na si Adarian. Ikaw, Adarian, fangirl ka. Yung mga ginagawa. Din ako ng dilawan yan na fangirl. Gago talaga. Anyways, solid sila eh. So, solid. Ganun talaga mga solid na tao.
Passion na talaga
yun. I mean, you saw it. I mean, you see Mark, di ba? Ba't ako in-attack na nila? Anyways,
I'm
going back.
I'm feeling it now. Meron ano.
Yeah, you could see it. Ba't ako, di ba?
Lalo ikaw.
So talagang ako yung parang liaison officer.
Ikaw yung nakatira sa Twitter eh. Hindi ako nakatira sa Twitter.
Lalo sa Twitter, like, IS. Tanggalin ko yung K, lagay like, ko, oh, it's again.
Like, anong nila? Anong feeling nila?
Ganito. I think this is how they're approaching it. First of all, edi umalis yung mga talagang hindi totoong ano, progressive. Ito yung mga tapo. So ano to? Cleansing to. Go. Diyan kayo kay Isko kasi paras kayo. Yun yung attack nila na paras trapo. So that's one lie. To purge the second is, yeah, it's understandable for them to do now because mahina si Lenny or now or relatively or she's not clear. But once she gets into the race and picks up momentum, magbabalikan yung mga yan. So they expect even some people in the Ascend side, if ever Isko loses steam, they could go and, you know, kind of switch to the Lenny side. So parang their point is, this could be just an... And the third one is like, good, para ma-pressure si Lenny to run, right? Good. Kasi that's good because if Lenny is ganun, talagang maganda na ma-pressure siya, di ba? So for some people, they welcome this as kind of a, you know, inspiration factor because parang sa tingin nila, Lenny is better when she's underdog, no? When she feels talaga a hopeless case. When everyone underestimates her, that's where she's more comfortable. Then everyone expects her to do very well. So I think that's the preliminary way of how they're really approaching it. And remember, last time we discussed this, di ba? Na parang, maybe the problem with Lenny's strategy was, of course, my counter argument to that is that pag ipit ka ng Marcoses and Dutertes, you don't have much room for maneuver. But our argument is that sayang yung more progressive, more center left, kasi liberal naman, hindi naman talaga left mga yan, more center right, mga pro business, pro ano mga yan. Sana from the beginning, talagang ganun siya, grassroots, progressive. So parang you could say, then so be it. If yung mga stalwarts ng Liberal Party ay nagdi-defect, then so be it, right? And if great people like Samira are you know, going to the Isko side, then that's a pressure. That's a reason for Lenny to prove her mettle. That if she runs, she'll be even better for people of Mindanao. That she'll be even better for Muslim Filipinos, our Muslim brother and sister. So good. Let it be a competition or challenge. So I think that's how they're gonna look at it. What is our time, by the way?
Mga 40 minutes. So, ano, we're...
Oh, just... Okay.
So, I have another question naman. So, let's bring in names. Sa mga names dun sa associated sa Lenny side. And where do they stand right now? Si Trillanes. Where does he stand in the whole Lennyverse? In the whole Lenny universe? Kasi he's saying na if Lenny doesn't run, I will run. Para
So ano ang there could be a Trillanes Pacquiao conversation because there's a Trillanes Pacquiao Lenny conversation. So if yun. Lenny doesn't run, then Trillanes Pacquiao. Trillanes as vice president of Pacquiao.
Yun. I saw
a I don't think Pacquiao will run under Trillanes. Will he? Yeah. I mean, I just don't think so.
I saw a post from Franco Mabanta na parang giving a clue sa ganun. Na baka yun nga yun eh. So yun din ang nakita ko. So ikaw, How does
I don't have info on that. So, but I know that Lenny Trillanes and Pacquiao are talking.
And how does the Lenny side look at Trillanes right now?
A lot of them like Trillanes.
Okay.
They see him as someone who stood up, na matapang, parang kumaga, kung may Dalima ka, may Trillanes ka. Mm-hmm. But there are also many people who like Lenny but not Trillanes. You know, they're saying, well, the guy was a coup plotter how many times, you know. The guy is anti-Duterte, but is he really as progressive as we think? And then there are other people saying, is like, we're not sure if he's the force multiplier that you need. Maybe you can get Chris Aquino or better get, you know what I'm saying, Pacquiao. So there are many arguments. And yeah, and things have been hard for Trillanes, right? Like, he has been positioning himself as the given tandem. And yet Lenny has been saying anything but affirming that, right? Like, it's like Lenny's talking to everyone, essentially saying, don't be too fast. In fact, we saw already that when Lacson was talking to Lenny, right? Na inis na inis si Trillanes. And then I think when Sambayan had to come in and say, oh, so what? I mean, like, quiet ka lang dyan. We're discussing here. Parang hindi ka entitled to that position of vice presidency. And then, let's not forget, by the way, he ran for vice president already in last elections. I think was he last? I think. So that's the thing. And like, ano bang machinery, for instance, will Trillanes bring to the picture? And the thing is, like, Lenny is already seen as a threat. If you put Trillanes there, baka the more matrigger yung other side. While if you bring in someone, quote unquote, not as that side, right? Even like Pacquiao, even though alam mo maraming galit kay Pacquiao in the DDS camp, it might soften the blow or something like that.
And same base si ano eh, you know, Trillanes and...
Exactly. Yun nga eh. So there are many arguments to be made against that, right? Yeah, okay. But next, fairness to Trillanes, right? The guy is decidido, right? Which is what you cannot say about some other people, right? So in fairness to Trillanes, he made it very clear. He wants to run as a vice president, at least, no? And who knows? Push comes to shove, he'll run for the president. And, you know, if Trillanes runs for the president, he could be like... He's gonna be the magulo guy there, right? He's gonna go after all of them, right? He will attack all of them. He will even attack Isko. If Isko is not tough enough, he'll attack all of them. So maybe liberals will welcome that. Okay, maybe you can question the chances at all, but we have a guy to essentially be the judge of
at least you won't be quiet if Lenny backs out.
Hindi kami pathetic. Hindi kami pathetic na walang-wala, di ba? Naasa lang kay Isko.
Maririnig kami.
So that's an interesting possibility, yeah. If not probability, that, you know, if Lenny really says no, wala eh, no choice. Trillanes said, bala, boy, I'm just gonna run. Win or lose, I'm just gonna go there and like bring hell to all of these other guys, right?
Next name. I want to talk about then, coming from the Lenny universe, okay? This guy, I really like yung kanyang ginagawa sa social media ngayon, sa TikTok, okay? Chel Jocno.
Wow. Chel Jocno. Yeah.
Ano ang tingin kay I know people from the opposition side loves Chel Jocno. Talagang nakikita ko 'yon. Talagang merong love talaga dito kay Chel Jocno. I'm seeing na possible VP candidate, pero syempre he's aiming for senator. What are you hearing about Chel?
Well, Chel really likes to be a legislator. Like his father, right? Baka for him anong size ng vice president, di ba? Like, you don't even know he's gonna be your president, right? So I think for Chel, kabaliktaran siguro ni Pacquiao, no? It's like he rather likes to be in the legislature than the executive. If especially if it's vice presidency. So I think really Chel wants to go there and do what his father did and all of that. Well, as far as Chel is concerned, I think it could be the Bernie Sanders of the Philippines. That's kind of how I look at it. Like cool lolo. Like cool progressive lolo.
But how about like the fact Bernie's... na ano? Sorry. How about the fact na he is still he's running as an independent and not with liberal this time?
Which brings me to the second issue. Like, you know, that was the second issue.
Sorry.
I think Chel Jocno is showing the way to a new liberalism to the Philippines, right? Okay. A kind of a rebranding, right? A kind of cool, non-self-righteous, not too overly padisente. My conviction, malinis, spotless background, you know what I'm saying? Kind of sincere, genuine stuff, non-trapo, essentially non-trapo liberalism. Which is what I would love. I'll just be brutally honest about it. So kind of Sanders-ish, right? The same way if you look at Bernie Sanders, he called out all these Hillary Clinton trapos, right? In Democratic Party, right? And he changed the game. So that's so much so that Biden had to already incorporate Bernie Sanders' idea. Kaya Sanders was not too bitter na eventually pinili si Biden because Biden had to eventually bring in the Bernie boys, Bernie bros, right? Bernie bros. So I think Shell could have that effect. I mean, win or lose, I said Shell could be a major factor in relaunching and revolutionizing what progressive left liberal really means in the Philippines. Because I think for a very long
Shell
time...
Shell will still side with Lenny? Or... anong, or
yes and no. I think Shell is really... Have you seen? I mean, the position of Shell is not too... I mean, again, this might sound crazy, but I mean, the same way that Isko is like trying to reach straight to the people and everyone says, don't be threatened by me, I'm not a specific camp. Kind of Chell is doing that, right? So you have artistas, Vice Ganda, whatever. Ganda. Who could be DDS, who could be whatever. You know what I'm saying? I'm saying Vice Ganda is DDS, but I'm saying like artistas who have appeal across the board are endorsing Chell. So if you're Chell, why should I confine myself to a discredited brand, right? When I can present myself, I'm Chell Jokno. I'm Jokno. Who cares about, you know, I'm Jokno. And I'm a human rights lawyer. You get me? You're going to get human rights. You're going to get democracy. Forget about everything else, right? So remember, Bernie Sanders is an independent who is like pampagulo lang within the Democratic Party. I mean, he's still an independent in the Senate. So I think Chell is kind of that. I think Chell is the Bernie Sanders.
He's starting to find this voice now. Nakakatawa.
Yeah. And I think Chell is giving a voice to alternative liberalism in the Philippines. This kind of new liberalism, which is cool, which is non-judgmental, which is non-self-righteous, which is non-trapo, right? Non-oligarchish, but at the same time, very strong on human rights. And look at Chell Jokno, ilang beses siya inatak ni Presidente Duterte. Tinawanan lang niya. Parang, eh. You know what I'm saying? Hindi siya pikon, hindi siya insecure, tumawa lang siya, tapos magti-tiktok lang siya. I mean, honestly, Chell could be a big, big factor. Nice. We're not seeing it now, but 10, 20 years down the road, they said, thanks to Chell, we found a new liberal progressive Filipino party or liberal progressive Filipino.
Good point. Good point. The last naman I will say naman.
Oh, sorry. Just sabaw na ako. I think mag-midnight na. Yeah, let's go.
How about naman how they would play into all of this? How about the Aquinos?
I have no idea. You tell me, where's Chris Aquino?
I don't know. Hindi ko din alam. This includes Chris and Bam.
Yeah.
Pero I mean, they're the next generation of Aquinos who will carry that name in the future.
But how did going back again, isn't that what I'm saying? Like, maybe we're gonna move towards a post-liberalism already.
Yeah, yun yung tanong ko eh. Does Lenny need to step away from the Aquinos? Or will Bam play a major role dun sa kanyang kandidat? The liberals should really take a look at this. Yun sa Facebook ni Bam Aquino has been the target ng mga anti-Marcos. If you look at the haha ratio, actually, ganito kay Facebook eh. Yung haha na yan is a form of bullying eh. Pero yung haha...
Yeah, mockery.
Dami nung haha sa mga martial law post ni Bam Aquino. Yun ang napapansin ko talaga. So, where will the Aquinos... What role will the Aquinos play in this push na ginagawa ni Lenny? So I think that's a interesting question to
that's ask. a very important point. Yeah. I think
Bam and Chris.
Yeah, I mean, I think we're in a situation whereby I think the Lennys, even definitely the Joknos, are saying we have to move to a new era.
Yeah.
Aquinos will be there, but not as central as they used to be. So essentially the ideology
is the party color din eh. Yellow is the yellow ribbon from
but I think that was what Mar was trying to do, right? Mar was trying to create a more liberal
Mar went all in sa yellow eh. I mean, not sa policy, more on sa
Think the long-term hope of Mar was it goes beyond the Aquinos. I mean, all due respect to the Aquinos, but you don't want ideologies especially great ideology like liberalism and human rights to be just, you know, defined by one family or not, right? You want to go beyond that.
Rojas nga, we're hearing rumors, di ba, na baka posibleng over the bakot na din sa ibang side na din. Hindi ko nalang sasabihin. I mean,
especially if Lenny doesn't, I mean, of course, everyone can guess, right? Practical lang naman yung mga yan.
Pero nga, like, for example, si Bam Aquino, so what role should he play?
That's my point. You honestly, I don't know much to say. I mean, you get it, right? I mean, if I'm a guy who has a lot to say on a lot of people. I mean, have you seen it? I'm struggling to give you like... I'm sorry. I'm really sorry. I'm really, really sorry. No offense.
Like Chris Aquino, I really like Chris. I've been saying this for a very long time. The
she's feisty. She's feisty. Like, I mean, she's feisty. I mean, like, Bam is a great guy. But as a politician, I think he still has to prove himself. You know, being a senator while another Aquino is in president, I mean, I don't think that was really time for you to prove your mettle. You prove your mettle when you're really under very difficult political circumstances, right?
For the past 5 years, Bam has not been...
Let's see if Bam can become again a senator under the current circumstances, and let's see how he behaves. Ako naman, I'm not saying the Aquinos are done. Maybe we're just gonna have a little bit Lilo moment for them.
Kasi I'm hearing that Chris Aquino can join sa Team Isko. Yun ang, there are rumors.
I won't be surprised. But of course, Isko has to be careful because he doesn't want to be. I mean, if the Chel joke, I'll tell you, if Chel joke, no, it doesn't want to be, right, associated, even more for Isko. That's what I'm saying. So, yun lang. I mean, like, you might, like, Chris Aquino is, you know, great celebrity, very interesting person, feisty and all. But if ang issue mo is you don't want to consolidate the never Dilawan side.
Yeah, yun na yun. Aquino, you bring Aquino to the ticket, di ba? So, medyo malaking issue yun. So, yun nga, interesting.
And just to say this, Marco, Ninoy did his job for the country. Noynoy did his job. Corey did their job. I mean, like, why should we expect all the time Aquinos to be there to save the country and all? I just don't get it. They did already what they did for the country. Like, you disagree? Okay, that's your issue. Bahala sa buhay mo. But what I'm saying, like, if you believe in the Aquinos, they've done how much more they should do for the country. Time for others. Time to move forward. I'm not saying they shouldn't do anything. I'm just saying, like, it should be around about them all the time.
Inocentric na. Oh.
Yun lang sa akin. Because the more you do it, then it becomes a Marcos versus Aquinos. And you don't want
it. Kasi sa akin, ha, ito, from someone na from my perspective naman, na it was the spirit of people power that catapulted Pinoy into the presidency noong 2010 after his mom died, di ba?
Right.
Pero ang problema nga, since yun ang ginamit niya, it was the first one to be attacked by the Dutertes. Right. And the Dutertes did a very good job. And sinong nakinabang nung inatake yun ng mga Dutertes? Yung mga Marcos. Mm-hmm. O kaya ngayon, it comes full circle. The Marcos are the person, the BBM is the person to beat sa candidacy. Diba? So
I'll put it this way, Mark Segura, as my final points on this issue. So I asked some, I think sinabi ko, isn't it interesting to say that the sins of the father are not, you know, the sins of the son? And then at the same time, whatever the father did na quote-unquote achievement, ika-claim mo. So ano ba achievement mo as yourself? So when I raised that to some BBMers people, they said, what about the other side? Sige, Ninoy was great, but you know what I'm saying? So that's the problem here, right? That's the problem. So for me, I hope to see Bam Aquino proving that, you know, he can be successful on his own terms, right? Become a governor, become a mayor. You know what I'm saying? Be a mayor. Why not? Why? I mean, Chris, go become a governor in Pampanga, Tarlac. Go be a governor. Help Tarlac. Something about Hacienda Luisita. Right? What I'm saying? No, be governor, be executive, do something like that. Nag senator na si Bam, di ba? Do something executive. Prove your mettle, come forward on your own terms. Oh, okay, bonus na lang kung Aquino ka, and by that time Aquino's name is hopefully, you know, it most likely will be better, right? In terms of resonance. But you know, win on your own merit. I mean, that's what I like about Isko. Hindi siya anak ng isang politiko, hindi ito on a silver platter. I'll just be brutally honest. Look at all the other candidates, especially the other side. Anak ni ganito at anak ni ganito. What is your own? That's where Isko is very compelling. Again, I'm not endorsing Isko. I'm just saying, in fairness kay Isko, he's running on his own merit. You can say, fake yan, whatever. But it's his own merit. So, yan din ang advice ko. Bam! Okay, go! prove yourself on your own merit, go out and under circumstances kung saan hindi kayong hegemonic power, no? I mean, do that. And I'm sure Bam has a lot to offer to the country and I'm sure he can do well. So go and do that. Yun lang sa akin, no. Uh-oh. Thanks Mark. That was like, whoa. Nasabaw na yata.
Like, but, good,
but that was good, oh. Ang ganda nung points natin. I didn't anticipate that I'll give you those answers. Like, it just came out. I mean, like, that's very interesting. Ano, please, i-release mo to, ha. Basahin ko. I'll go through this. Ang dami mga interesting points na lumabas. Yeah.
Kasi they all play a role, eh. They all play a role sa of Lenny course. Sa Lenny universe. True. Na wants to go to Malacanang. And, di ba?
All I'm saying, Mark, is like, yung all of them will have a script pero kung ang script mo ba is for lead actor or supporting actor ganun, yeah. Dun tayo medyo magkakaroon na adjustments. Of course they'll be around. Yun lang. I mean, like any beautiful movie, hindi isa lang yung ano mo, lead actor mo forever. Mag-evolve yung story, di ba? Mm. Even your secondary actors can become primary actors. You know what I'm saying? Kaya nga love ko yung Game of Thrones eh. Lahat pwede yung maging protagonist. Lahat may story. Hindi lang isa ganun. So, feeling ko, dapat ganun ang politika natin. Yung script ay mayaman, rich, there are many good leaders, hindi lang isa, hindi lang dalawa. And just on this, I want to end on this point. Let's not make our politics family X versus family Y. And I hope Isko Moreno, whatever happens in these elections, kind of emphasizes that point, no? Whether through his own performance or in words, na sana people become our leaders based on their own merit, hindi lang what family they come from. It's not bad to have good family, I'm just saying. But sana naman, people run on their own merit, no? And hindi tayo bumoboto dito because skills is not necessarily inherited, right? Skills sometimes is developed. It's earned, right? It's enhanced, it's harnessed. And I'll be honest, I always prefer people who are self-made. I always have way more respect for self-made people. I'll just put it that way. So thank you very much, Marco. Do you have some final points on this issue?
Yun lang. Actually, it's refreshing kasi I was able to control myself and I was able to learn more about doon sa possible na Lenny's path to Malacañang. Na meron pala. Meron pala.
Yeah, diba? Meron. There's a logic.
Oh, diba? So, yun. And marami pang layers right. Dito sa buong Lenny story. So this week makikita natin. So this will come out Wednesday. Baka marami nang
nangyari. So we don't know, baka may announcement, but hopefully the announcement will make this episode even more worthwhile. But regardless what happens, who runs, I think we discussed where the Philippines should go, especially yung liberalism in the Philippines, whatever that means, right? Salamat. So that's our episode X, yeah. Very special episode. Yeah. Thank God. Salamat for everyone supporting us.
The real Lenny episode. Kasi may sinasabi nila yung unang Lenny daw natin. Yeah. Parang hindi daw masyadong ano. Parang medyo. Pero ito, yun nga.
I don't know. We discussed Naga and everything. Oh. I don't know. So this is Lenny as a candidate episode. Yeah. The other one was just like Lenny episode in general. So this is, I think this is the deepest analysis of Lenny on the record. I don't, maybe off the record, there's smarter people out there. I don't know. But I'll just be brutal. I haven't seen a better analysis. And I'm not saying it's because of me. It's because of the interaction and the dialogue we're having. I really like this episode. I really like episode X, episode 10. And double looking forward, guys, to join us soon. By next week, we are going to have more or less, I think, the lineup of official candidates and all. Right? So we'll have even more to discuss. Marami salamat. Thank you very much, Mark. Marami salamat to everyone. God bless you. And Project Pilipinas. Please subscribe and support us on Apple, on Spotify. And I think nag-upload na rin kami dyan sa YouTube. So please find us. Thank you very much. And also, follow us on our own YouTube channels, Models of Manila, Politica 360, and of course, Facebook, Twitter, TikTok, we're all over the place, and Instagram, of course. Maraming salamat. God bless.